Hi, today's concept is thread life cycle. What is thread life cycle? Means every thread has some life cycle, like a person. Suppose if you take a human being, there is a life cycle, a child, later youngster, later older, like dig some after that older he will be dead. Like this, a thread also have some life cycle. Thread creation, after creating it will perform some logic. After performing logic, it will go to some wait or sleep state. Again it will perform some logic. After completion of the total logic of the thread, means if the total job is completed, the thread will be going to the terminated. Only we have an object, but thread will be the terminated. So this is the life cycle. So today we are discussing about the life cycle. What is what are the states of a thread? We will go each and everything. So before going to when the thread will be created, the thread will be created after start only. After start, whenever you are calling start method, the thread will be created and run, and it will run. But think one point. Suppose my class is thread demo. It is extending thread, means if I create, just I am overriding run method. In that run method, simply I am not writing a simple, I am writing a simple logic. Now if you see, if I create my class object thread to demo, t1 is equal to new thread to demo, t1 dot start. Now if you see, when thread will be created, t1 dot start. T1 dot start means internally the JVM or JVM will call some native methods of operating system level methods, and it will create the thread, and the thread will execute this run method. Right, clear this point. But when thread is created after calling start method, but when thread is in new state, it is not live state. Still it is not a live state. Like a child in a mother's womb is not a live state, he is born. Like that, thread is not live in this statement, he is not created still, but thread is in new state. But thread is in new state. Suppose if you create thread object, if you create a thread object in Java, internally what is that meaning, means t1 dot get state means what you will print, it is new state. New state you will print, it will print new state, because thread is not created, but thread is in new state. It is a new state, is nothing but is a not alive state. It is a not live. The thread is terminated, thread is not created at all. Best example, I am printing t1 dot get state. Actually thread is not created. If thread is not created, means it will have any state or not no state. Definitely it will have a state, because thread is not created, but thread object is created. Right, this thread object is representing the thread, right? But t1 is a thread object. T1 is a thread object, and it is representing the thread. Which thread? The future, in future one thread will be created. When t1 dot start means one thread is created, that thread is representing by the t1 object. Now if you print t1 dot get state, means what will print? If you here thread demo t1 equal to new thread demo, I created an object for thread class or thread subclass. Now thread is created or not? Thread is not created. Carefully note this point, thread is not created at this point. But if you print t1 dot get state, which state will print? New state will print. How it is possible? Thread is not created, but it is printing the state. Because in future maybe thread is created when if you call t1 dot start. If you not call t1 dot start, only thread object is there, but thread will not create. But in future maybe thread will be created if you call t1 dot start. That thread is representing by the t1 object. Now if I call t1 dot get state, what is the output? New state. After new, here, so whenever you are creating a thread object, thread will not create, but thread state will be created. That is a new state. New state means, what is the meaning of new state? New state means thread is not created, but in future maybe it will be created, but one object for the thread is allocated, one memory is created for the thread object. That is representing new. New means thread object is created, but thread is not created. We are allocating some memory for thread object, not for thread. Whenever thread will be created, t1 dot start means thread will be created. So once a thread is created, what is the state of the thread? Before calling t1 dot start, what is the state? New state means thread is created, thread is not created, but thread object is created. That object state is new state. Okay, now if I call t1 dot get state the second time, now if you see, new will print and runnable will print. What is the means here? What is the state? Runnable state means it is running. Like some states are there. So what are the states of thread? New is the first state, second state is runnable, next states are waiting state, blocked state, time waiting state, and terminated states. These are the states of the thread. Total how many states? 6 states. So what are the states and how we are going? If you see this diagram, if you see, the first state is new. The first state is new. When thread is entered into the new, what is the meaning of new? New means thread is not created, just a thread object is created. What is the meaning of new? Thread is not created, just t1 object is created. After creating t1, what is the state of t1? It is a new, means thread is not created, means thread is not alive. Now after creating t1, I am calling t1 dot start method. Thread is created or not created still. After calling start method, thread will be created. Now what is the state? It will comes from new state to runnable state. What is the state of thread now? Runnable. Why runnable? It is changing the state. The thread is created. In this state, thread is not created, just memory allocated for thread object. In this state, thread is created and the thread object is t1. Now it is entered into new state to runnable state. In this state, the thread will execute the code. What it will do? Thread will execute the code. So first state is new state, second state is runnable state. What first state means? Thread object is created. What second state? Thread is created and also execution also starts, means run method is executing by the thread. That is runnable state. Suppose I created two threads. T1 is my first thread and T2 is my second thread. Now T1 dot start, T2 dot start. Now how many threads will be created? Two threads will be created, T1, T2. Now some part of T1 is executing. After completing T2, again some part of T1 will execute. Like this process is done by operating system. operating system, because processor will, JVM will execute, but which thread need to execute, it is not depending on your JVM, it is depending on your operating system. Your JVM will execute the code because your Java code can understand by your JVM only, not operating system. But which thread need to execute first and which thread need to execute next, this is depending on operating system. In Windows operating system it is different, in Linux is different. Operating system to operating system, the thread scheduler, what is thread scheduler? Thread scheduler is the executing the threads in one order, particular order, based on its implementation. We can't mention this order it will execute, we can't mention the order, because that is depending on thread scheduler. Now what your operating system is doing, it is giving a chance to T1. Now JVM will execute T1 related code. After OS will wait, it will go into the wait state, means it will stop the execution of T1 and it will start the T2. Now JVM will start the T2 execution. OS will tell which thread you need to execute, T1 or T2 or T3, T4, T5. Who will tell to the JVM? OS. OS will specify to the JVM. JVM will execute the threads, but which thread need to execute, that OS will specify. Okay. Now T1 is executing. T2, at the time of T1 executing, what need T2 need to do? It need to some waiting or something it needed, right? So what OS will do, some quantum time period, means like 1 millisecond or 2 milliseconds, we can't mention the time period, what is the time period it is give to the each thread at a time, we can't mention, because it is depending on operating system implementations. For example, 1 millisecond, the quantum time period is 1 millisecond. Now OS quantum time period is 1 millisecond. Now T1 will execute 1 millisecond. After 1 millisecond, T2 will execute. Again T2 will execute 1 millisecond. Again T1 will execute 1 millisecond. After one completion of this 1 millisecond, again T2 will execute 1 millisecond. Like this the process will be continued. Suppose T1 is executing 1 millisecond, at this time what T2 will do? Means it is in still in runnable state only, but in runnable state there are again two more states are there. If you see this diagram, the runnable state, this is runnable state, this runnable state contains ready state and running state. What is the meaning of ready state and running state? Suppose T1 thread is executing, means it is in running state. T1 is executing, it is in running state. At the time of executing T1, what T2 will do? It need to wait, allocating some time. Whenever our processor will allocate the time or control to the T2, then only it will execute. Until the T2 will reside in ready state, it is ready to execute but not executing. After T1, after 1 millisecond, T1 will go to the ready state. Now T2 will come. T2 will come to the running state. So there are in runnable state there are two more states. What is that? Ready state and running state. Ready state means it is waiting for the quantum time period. If operating system allocates some time to the thread, then it will go to the running state. It is not allocating the time to the particular thread, it is in ready state, means waiting for the time which is provided by the operating system. If thread got the time, 1 millisecond time, then it will execute, means it is in running state. If the thread is waiting for that 1 millisecond time, that is called ready state, it is ready for executing. So this is runnable state. In runnable states, again two states, ready state, running state. Ready state means the threads are waiting for the time period, quantum time period given by the operating system. Once if thread got time period, it will execute the run method, means it is in running state, ready state, running state. But if you print suppose T1 T1, T2, two threads are there. If you print T1, T2, T1 is executing, whenever the executing T1, if you print T1 dot get state, it is printing runnable. Just in the example, yes, so I am showing same here. In this example, just see the output. Here, if you execute this program, new runnable means before creating the thread, new state, after creating the thread, runnable state, in main method also runnable state means once thread is created, if it is waiting for quantum time period or getting the time period, both will print runnable. Means maybe the runnable belongs to ready state or runnable belongs to running state. But OS contains the data, the thread is in ready state or runnable running state, but your JVM doesn't have any information about ready state or runnable state. That's why it will print runnable directly. So in this situation, your JVM doesn't know of the state of ready or running. Who will know? Operating system. Operating system will knows the state of the thread. State of the thread, is that ready or is that running? But what JVM will know? Running. This is the name the JVM will know. This is the names JVM don't know. That's why if it is waiting for the time period or if it is got the time period and executing, in the both the scenarios it will print the state as runnable, not print ready and running. Most important interview question. Thread dot get state means why always runnable is coming, why not ready is coming, why not running is coming? Because these two states are known by the operating system, and these two states are not don't these two states are don't known by the your JVM. JVM will knows the only runnable state. Internally runnable state, against two states are there, but about those two states JVM doesn't have any idea about those two states. Only operating system has an idea about those two states. Now if you print T1 dot get state, always runnable will print, but not ready or not running will not print. Just remember, it is an interview question mostly. Next. Okay, after thread is created, before thread created, new state is there. After thread created, maybe memory allocated or not allocated, it is in runnable state. If memory not allocated, means if time is not allocated, it is in ready state. If time is not allocated, that is running state. But ready and running state both are comes under runnable state only. Okay, now two states are completed. Now again, suppose sometimes what happen, I'm going to explain about some more states. Suppose the thread need to sleep 2 seconds, or thread need to wait 5 seconds or 6 seconds. Means a thread is waiting for something, then it is going to the timed waiting state. Means some more states are there. What are the states? Waiting state, timed waiting state, terminated state, blocked state. In future classes, actually these states I will explain in detail. Because suppose when thread is created T1 and it is executing run method, at the time of executing run method, what I do? Thread dot sleep means the current thread is going to the sleeping state for 2 seconds. Means this thread will not execute for 2 seconds. On that scenario, sleep of 2 seconds, 2000 milliseconds. On this scenario, which state it will go? Timed waiting state means waiting. This thread is waiting on some time. That is why timed waiting state. Suppose if I write T1 dot wait, then if T1 dot wait means thread is going to wait for some object or something. In future I will explain in synchronized block what is object level lock, what is class level lock, what is this type of concepts I will explain. On that time you will get this methods explanation very well. Now just to understand basics, if I write t1 dot wait means what is happening? T1 dot wait means thread is going to the waiting state. Suppose if I mention 2000, now what is that meaning? Thread is going to waiting state until two seconds only. After 2 seconds it is going to the runnable state. This wait with milliseconds will comes under time waiting, wait without time functioning comes under waiting state. So after new state and runnable state, there are two more states are there: waiting state, timed waiting state. For best example, practical example, one person is created means one person is born means he is in new state. Like consider, instead of thread, just consider one person. I have one person. Yeah, this person is born in this earth. Now he is in new state. Now he is grow up and he is doing some work. Now in which state he is there? Runnable state, because he is doing some work. Now after doing some work he is going to sleep. Now how much time he will go to the sleep? 6 hours. Now he is in which state? Now he is in a waiting state, timed waiting state, means 6 hours he need to wait. Now suppose there is a note mentioned time, I am waiting for my friend. Suppose this person is waiting for his friend, and his friend is in which time he will arrive he don't know, but he need to wait until his friend is arrived. So he don't know the time, but he is waiting. That is called waiting time, waiting state. So now this person is not doing any work and waiting for his friend. Now his friend, whenever he will come and he will do, both will do some work. Up to now he is in waiting state, waiting for his friend. How much time he will wait? We don't know. Whenever, if his friend come in 1 hour, he will wait 1 hour. If his friend comes in 2 hours, he will wait up to 2 hours. So we don't know the hours or times. Now this person is in waiting state, waiting for his friend. Suppose this person is waiting for his friend up to 2 hours. I will wait, suppose I am the person, I will wait for my friend up to 2 hours. Within the 2 hours, if my friend arrived, I will continue my work. If my friend is not arrived within the 2 hours, I will not bother. I will do some other work. I will not waste my time. So in this period, in this state, what he is waiting up to 2 hours means timed waiting. He is waiting based on time. 2 hours I will wait, 3 hours I will wait. In previous state he is also waiting, but without time mention. I don't know, whenever my friend will arrive, I will wait up to my friend will arrive. So that is called waiting state. I will wait up to 2 hours. If my friend came, okay. If my friend not came, I will do some other work. That is called timed waiting. Waiting based on time, waiting based on some object or some person, like that. Now if this person want to do some work is there, he person is want to do some work. But if he want to do work, some line is there. Suppose in ATM he want to withdraw some money, but withdraw money is the work. If he want to do the work, some more members in the queue is there. He need to wait until those members are completed their work. So that is called blocking state. There is a difference between waiting state and a blocking state. Waiting state is I am waiting for some particular person, but blocking state is I want to do some particular task, but already some other persons are doing. If that persons are completed the task, I need to do, means blocking. I am blocking when up to some time. So this is blocked state. Now one person has waiting state, a timed waiting state, or blocked state. Waiting means he is waiting with time, that is timed waiting. If he want to do some task, but other persons are already doing the task, now that is called blocking state. after completing the person's duty, he is dead. Now that is called terminated state. Like this, thread also have some states: new state, runnable state, waiting state, timed waiting state, and blocked state and terminated state. These are the states. Waiting state will comes under wait method. If you call wait method, it is comes under waiting state. Wait with some time period, sleep with some time period will comes under timed waiting state. Now terminated, if the thread completed his task, means thread is completed his run method is executed completely. Now thread is dead. Now t1.getState means thread is dead, but t1 object is still available to us. So t1.getStart means thread is dead, its terminated state will come. Now suppose I've written some program like blocked. What is the best example for blocked? Synchronized concept. Whenever one thread will execute, up to executing first thread, second thread will never enter into that synchronized block. That type of concepts will be there in future. I will explain. That is called blocked state. Now join, if you call join method, join method will comes under which state? Waiting state or blocked state? Which state join method will comes? I will explain in next session what is join, what it will do, but just remember this thing. Yeah, it is through some, I need to handle try out. Now if you see, I am in run method, it is waiting state. Now this dot join means, I will explain what join method will do, I will explain later. Now join method is waiting in which state? Waiting state. So waiting state, wait method comes under waiting state. If you call wait method, what is the thread state? Wait. If you call join method, what is the thread state? Waiting only. If you call wait with some milliseconds, 200 or 2 seconds, now it is comes under timed waiting, means it will wait for 2 seconds. Otherwise sleep also comes under timed waiting state only. Terminated, if run method is completed, total code is completed, now the thread is terminated. Blocked, what is the best example of blocked? Synchronized. Suppose if I write synchronized method, only one thread will execute. Suppose I have a method, one thread is executing this method. Up to completing this thread, second thread will never enter into this state, means this t2 thread need to wait. Because t1 is executing my method, t2 need to wait. Wait means it is comes under blocking state. And one more example for blocking state is, suppose if you write please enter two numbers, means from the keyboard the user need to enter the two numbers. Suppose user is not entering the numbers, what the thread will go to? The thread is blocked, it is going to the blocking state. So input output requests, synchronized areas, these are comes under synchronized input output request, these are comes under blocked area. If task is completed, that is terminated. If wait method, sleep method, if suppose wait method, waiting time is completed, what the thread will go to? The again runnable state. If time waited state completed, it will go to the runnable state. If blocked is completed, it will go to the runnable state. But once terminated, it will not again restart, it will terminated, means it will not go to any other state. Terminated is the final state and new is the starting state. So in between new and terminated, how many states are there? Runnable, waiting, timed waiting, blocked. Suppose I have a doubt, I want to print these states. How can I print? t1.getStates. If I print t1.getStates, I can print. But I want to get states. So I want to compare, is that waiting or not? Like that, if I want to compare, yes, waiting or not, just I want to paste. You need to, but what I need to do, to stream. Yeah, here if you see, if I run here, here true is printing. So I am comparing state, but state is not a string. So converting state to string, and you need to again remember the spelling of that states, correct pronunciation spellings. So that's why that is the problem. If you want to compare which state, suppose if thread is in waiting state, I need to execute some logic. If thread is not in wait state, I need to execute some logic. Means I will write some if conditions. But comparing, how can I compare? I need to compare like this. But is that calling toString and again remembering that waiting, timed waiting, it is waste of time. That's why Java given inbuilt API, Java given inbuilt some class. The class is state. What is that? Enum. One java.lang package, in thread class one enum mentioned, that enum name is state. If you want thread to string, no need to convert to string, directly you can thread dot state. State, what is state? Thread dot state means it is in a enum mentioned in class dot waiting. Yeah, directly there is a enum, waiting is the variable is declared. Now again I will print true only. So in compared to previous one, this is the very easy. No need to remember the spelling, or no need to remember of state name, and no need to convert that state into string. These are the things no need. So that's why if you have any doubt, if you have the print compare the states, instead of comparing with string, converting into the string, just use the enum, state enum, that is mentioned in thread class, thread java dot lang dot thread dot state, that is the enum name, you can utilize that one. So these are the states: new state, runnable state, waiting state, timed waiting state, terminated state, blocked state. In future, yield method is there, join method is there. If each method, the thread in which state thread is executing, in which state thread is going to the data, I will explain each state in detail. Okay, so this is the one. If you see thread life cycle here, my thread new, my thread equal to new state, thread dot start, some runnable state, calling some blocking methods, wait, join, that is wait state, synchronized area, it's a blocked state, wait, sleep, this is timed waiting state, completion of run method, terminated state. These are the six states. But internally runnable state contains running state and ready state internally. So these are the ready state and running state, blocked, waiting, timed, terminated. How to print thread state? To converting to string is one model, and by utilizing the enum, thread dot state, it is given by default. Now sample program to print the thread states. Sample program is nothing but this is the sample program. So okay, this is, in this session I explained the thread life cycle, but in next session with examples like yield method, what is the thread life cycle, join method, what is the thread life cycle, sleep method, what is the thread life cycle, for each and every method we will discuss thread life cycle, from which line thread is created and which line thread is terminated, which line thread is going to waiting state or timed waiting state or blocked state or any other states. I will explain line by line in next sessions. Okay, I hope you understand. Thank you.